Hello and welcome to Soft Hints. In this video we will speak about functions and chapter number 3 from the book Think Python. This is really important topic, so I will split the videos in two separate parts. You can see some of the topics for this chapter here. In previous videos and chapters we saw how to use arithmetic operators, how to use some variables, expression statements and the order of the execution for these statements. And now we'll continue with really important topic, which is about functions. You can see the topics which will be covered here. And I want to say that a function is a named sequence of statements that is performing a given computation. And you can define your functions, you can use a built-in functions, and later you can reuse them in different situations for your needs. You can see some of the best practices for functions here. First one is that every function should have a proper name for the functionality that is doing. The next thing is that this function should do only one thing, and the thing for which it was designed, this function, and you shouldn't try to add new functionality to other functions in order to make them better and more generic ones. And next one is that each function is good to have documentation and some commands explaining what is the intent for this function and what should do and how it should behave. And finally, the function should be a short one. And this code depends on your needs and your project, but maybe 20, 50 or 100 lines, it's a good mark here. So let's start with the function calls. This is a simple function, you can see here type and 42. It's a built-in function, which means that it comes with the Python and you don't need to do anything for it instead of using it by putting the name of the function, which is type, and also 42, which is an argument in this case, and we can run this function and get the result. So in this case we get that 42 has a type and this type is integer. We can do the same for a character, and you can see that this letter here, it's from type string. And you can remember this statement that usually function takes an argument and returns a result. In this case, the take argument is A or 42, and the result is this output here, string. You can see another functions, for example, converting from string to integer by using function int. And you can provide a string which is a number, and as you can see you get a number. Also you can check a documentation for a given function in different ways. For example, using a Jupyter notebook you can use shift and tab, and you can check if this function has any documentation and some examples. You can see the examples here and explanation for this function. Let's check what is going to happen if we provide a string which is not a number. As you can see, we get an error, which is value error, and you face this error many times in Python, and you need to be able to understand what this error is saying to you. It's saying that you're providing an argument which is not the expected one for this function. And if you provide a better argument, for example a number which is a float one, you can use it, and as you can see this number here, the float one, is truncated, so we have 3 instead of 4 if you expect 4. And you need to be careful what is doing this function and how it's behaving. As you can see, the same is for this -2.3, we have -2. You can convert from integer, which is a whole number, to a float. And as you can see, we have float here, which is shown with .0. And you can do the same for other strings. For example, this is a string and now we are converting it to a float. You can do the reverse operation, convert a float to a string and also integer to a string. These are common operations when you're dealing with Python and programming, so you need to be able to understand what is a type, how you can convert from one type to another type, and also why types, some types are incompatible. So let's go on the other topic, which is math functions. So Python has models which provide useful functions for you. In this case, we are going to use a math model, which is collection from useful math functions. And we are going to do import of this model here. This is again really important to understand what is a model and how this model is working and how you can access information from this model. And we first import the model. Then we are going to use some functions from this model, for example, log 10. And we are going to do some computations here. As you can see, we are calculating some ratio from noise and a signal. The idea here is that you're using a model mat. You're asking for a function from this model by using a dot notation, which is really important in programming, and you will see it many times. And again, you can see documentation for this function by using shift tab, or in PyCharm you can point to the function and press control and click with the left button mouse and you'll be able to see the declaration of this function. Okay, so let's see another function. It's sin, which is for sinus, and you can get the angle and some conversions from one measurement to another with this function. You can use another value, for example p, by using again this model, and you can get the approximation of p and use it in your programs. As you can see, again you can see documentation for this function and what it's doing. And this is one of the recommendations which I can give you. Always try to see how the function is working and read its documentation to avoid surprises when you're using functions and to save some time for you. And also, when you're using functions, try to use meaningful and descriptive commands to your functions. This is going to help you, even you, in future. And it's going to save you time when you need to fix something which was written 1 or 2 years ago. So let's move on composition, which is one of the most powerful features in programming, that you can combine different building blocks and make them in compositions. For example, we can use a mat sin function, then provide many variables, some operators, and finally we can get a result from all this. Let's check the result. Here there is an error. It seems the degrees is not defined. So if you have a variable which is not defined or a function, you'll get an error like this. So in order to avoid this error, you can provide a value. And as you can see right now, we will have a result. Otherwise, you'll get errors, which is name error. And the name error is saying that you're trying to use a name. Is it a variable or a function which is not defined? So anytime you see this error, try to find where you have this name and why it's not defined. So let's move on another compositions. You can see a functions which has argument, another functions which has another parameter. You can see that, for example, here we can assign a variable and having on the right side of the equal sign another variable. and this is pretty fine. But if you try to use a statement, for example, to define a variable, some arithmetic operator like multiplying on something, and to return the value from another function, another variable, sorry. So this statement is wrong and it's not going to work, as you can see. And maybe it's going to work in some other languages and it's possible to return a result. But I prefer to avoid these confusing and misleading compositions, because even for you they can be misleading in one ear. And also another interesting principle in programming is keep it simple, stupid. And I will put a link in the description below why this is important, because you save a lot of time for the people which are working with these functions and for you when you need to do some changes. Okay, so far we saw only built-in functions which come with Python, but you want also to define your own functions, which is a really nice feature. And you can see a definition of a function here. We have a def, which is a keyword, which is defining that we have a function definition. Then we have the name of the function, which is print lyrics. You can see the notation for naming functions in Python here. So we are using lowercase letters with underscore. And finally, you can see a bracket, which indicate that this function doesn't take any arguments, as we saw in the past. And this is the body of the function, which is the code, which is what the function is doing in general. So you have a header, the first part, and you have a body. And you can see that here we have single and double quotes in one single statement, and this is perfectly okay and you can use it, as you can see. So we defined the function, but maybe you were expecting to have output, for example, to print this value, and this is not the case because this is only defining the function and it's not executing this function. In other words, we defined the function, we have a new object from type function, and we can see some information for this object using type and print. And in order to execute a already defined function, you need to do a call. And a call of the function is done by using the name of this function, brackets, and also giving the arguments, if any. Let's see here. So as you can see, right now we are executing this function and returning a result from this function, which is printing something. We can call one function from another function, and this can be done by defining the call in the body of the other function. You can see here we have definition of a second function. So far nothing is happening, and if we execute the second function, is going to execute the previous one. And this is really important to be able to understand how the flow of the program is working and to be able to follow the execution of the program. Otherwise you have difficult times working with programming and functions in general. Here let's see definitions and usage of functions. So we need first to create a function before to use it, and also we can execute one function from another, but only if we execute these functions. If we just define them, nothing is going to happen. And if we invocate a given function, in this case repeat lyrics, which is going to execute, the first line is print lyrics. So this function is going to change the execution flow and is going to call this one. And after this one is executed once, it's going to execute the second line, which is going to repeat the same function. And as you can see, we have two times printed the lyrics of this song, which is not as in the real song. And also, important note is that in order to use a function in Python, this function should be defined prior to be accessed, and let's see what is going to happen otherwise. Again, you have a name error, as we saw in the past, and this name error is saying that you're trying to access function which is not defined yet, and you need first to define it and then to use it. Let's come back to flow of the execution and why it's important. Can you predict what is going to be the output of this program and why? You can pause the video and try to answer of this question. And if you think that we'll get 1, 2 and 3, you're wrong. And the answer is that first we are executing a function's repeat lyrics, then we are calling print lyrics 1, after that we are calling print lyrics 3, and then print lyrics 2. And that's why we have this result here. So this means that the flow execution is defined from this function here and not from the function definitions. And this is really important. The program is executing from the top to the bottom. So we are creating object from this for this function, the same for the rest, but we are executing the functions only here, and we start the execution of the first function here. So you can try do a debug or analyze some other functions like this in order to understand how the execution flow of a given program is working, because this is really important topic. And let's go on the last subchapter for today, which is parameters and arguments. And this is another important topic. As you can see, some functions could have one argument, another could have two, and some could be without any argument. Also the same is for the return values. You can have different types for the arguments, for example string, you can have integer, you can have another function, you can have composition. And let's check, we're defining a function print twice, we're giving a variable, this variable is going to be used in the function as a local variable. So using this method executions, we are going to print several times the values which are passed to these functions. You can see that we can provide more complex statements, for example multiplication of a given string 4 times, so we are going to have spam repeated 4 times, and this is going to be repeated 2 times. In other words, this statement here is executed before the function to be called, and only then the function is called and executed. That's why we have this result here. The same is going to happen with this function if we are trying to execute it. And the final note that I want to say is that when you're defining a function, there's no relation between the argument that you're using outside the function and inside the function. So here you have a variable with name Michael. You're providing this variable to the function. Later you have argument for this function, which is Bruce, and it's used as a local variable Bruce. And there's no relation between the name Bruce and the name Michael for this program. So if you have any questions, problems, or something it's not clear, please do a comment in the comment section below and I will try to answer in the next video. And in the next video we will see the rest of the topics that are in this chapter. Thank you for the good words that you are sharing above these videos, and if you like you can subscribe. See you next time.